Hey, what's up everybody? Xulus here, and today I'm going to show you how to configure Easy Drummer 2 within FL Studio 12. Pretty easy setup to do. I'm going to guide you through it. First off, if you'd like to look up here at the top, you have your browsers and your plugin database. Go ahead and click on this. That's your plugin database, and then you want to go to your generators. And this is where Easy Drummer would be installed. Now, Easy Drummer is a VST program, like any drumming program, so this would be a good setup for anybody that was using any VST drumming setup. So it doesn't necessarily have to be Easy Drummer, but I really do like this program because of the sound. So the first thing you do is you go ahead like I'm doing, drag and drop it. We'll just put it right here in the kick drum channel. And we'll let it load up real quick. This is the playlist over here, and then this is your mixer right here. And then this is the little mini channel thing that we have that you can actually add beats in and stuff like that if people use, but I don't use it that much. I actually just delete the other channels that I'm not using. And let's go ahead and delete those, because all the drums are going to be within this one program. So now when I hit a drum, it plays it. I prefer the metal sound on the stock version of Easy Drummer. There's a bunch of different other kits that you can download. This sounds good for me. Now, the trick is getting it configured within the mixer down here. As you can see, when we play, it all goes into channel 1. Well, it'd be nice to get those separated. So, you can do that simply by clicking on here, which is the settings, and then go to Processing tab, and then go Auto Map the Outputs. Now, this will remap the outputs to the correct channel, then go back over here, which is the Easy Drummer tab, and then go to the mixer. Now let's remix these channels to the correct. I'm going to go 2 through 13, and we just simply go in order like so. Seven takes a little bit of time, we'll get it there. Alright, so now we've got all these basically separated in their channels. Let's go ahead and play them. Yes. Okay. So now that we've got that done, the nice thing would be to do is get everything on this one main channel and all these separated off onto that, and then into the master channel, kind of making like a sub master. So let's go ahead and select this channel, press Control on your keyboard, and then just simply keep it held down and go over. I'm going to go up to 16, there might be 16 drums, and then right click on it and select track routing and create submix, and we can call it drums, and you press enter. There we go, we have a submix now. As you can see by our channel routing here, which is these wires, you can turn these wires off and on, but I kinda like it. When we look at the master channel, it is now routed from all the other channels into the submaster and then into the master. We go to the other channels, they are routed correctly by channel into the submaster. Yes. That's sort of what we were looking for. So now this is configured correctly. And you can hear it going around in the headset as well. It's correct. So when you hit a drum, this actually is on your right side. By the time you hit the snare, it is in the right place. Alright, so that's exactly what we wanted to do. So next, excuse me, I'm going to show you how to make a piano roll drum beat. So go up here by the Easy Drummer 64-bit thing, right click it, and select piano roll. You can also hit it up here in the piano roll, I believe it's right there. And then this is your piano roll, and you can make whatever beat you want. Just simply find the kick, you can just drag and find the kick wherever it is, right here it looks like, and make a kick beat. We're just going to make a simple, quick beat, and then we got our snare. Let's find our snare. Let's just put it in, make a simple beat. And find a hi-hat here, let's see. Alright, let's play that and see what we got here. Alright, pretty basic beat, right? Yeah, so that's cool. Obviously, you could mess with this and come up with whatever you wanted by holding control and the middle button. You can zoom in and out, make it bigger or smaller, give you some variety with that. And then also down here, this actually makes this very, very helpful, and you're going to need this a lot. This is your volume control for each drum. You can make it so it goes quieter and louder and stuff, and this will make it so it doesn't sound so computery, you know. So let's move it just a little bit and see what it sounds like here. Yep. So that's a really cool thing. Now, the other way you can go about this, and this is a really cool thing with Easy Drummer, is you can search through here and find a pre-made drum beat. We have everything in here, basically. You can find metal and basically find, you know, start, finish, and put together a whole track here. Down here like so. Fills and everything, and you can actually play this. And you can select it by holding down control and selecting all of them, and then drag and drop the whole thing up into here, and it'll actually create a piano roll for you. There you go. Pretty awesome, huh? So essentially you can make a whole band. Once you have a drummer, that's always a missing part, right? So anyways, if this tutorial helped you out on how to hook up Easy Drummer to FL Studio, hey, that's awesome, man. I really hope it does, and that's way cool. And anyways, I'd like to thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, just leave them in the comments, and I will try to get back to you. And you know what? As always, peace out, Igzulas.